Hey guys, this is Mikko, and obviously this is not a normal video since I'm not wearing my cap. No, really. There was something that happened this week that I feel like, in the name of honesty, I need to address, because on this channel I do a lot of painting videos and painting tutorials and live streams, and I think there is an impression that I sometimes give that is a false impression that painting is easy for me. My intention with this channel is not to convince you that painting is easy. It's not. My intention with this channel is to convince you that painting is worth it. So I think it's really important that I make this thing that happened very clear on how it felt on my part and what I learned from this experience, because honestly, despite it being so dramatic at the time, I think it was worth doing. This week I made this live stream, and unlike I normally do, I had enough time in my day to announce that I'm going to be doing a live stream in 3 hours. And then I went to the gym and took Vivi out for a walk because she needs a lot of attention and love. And then when I got home, I just barely had enough time to pull all of my stuff together and set up the live stream. You can see from the live stream itself that I had intended to shave before the live stream started, but no such luck. I had about 1 minute of extra time to make sure that all the settings were correct before the live stream started. So that's how busy I am. So the live stream theme was perspective, and I was doing this demo on how I use perspective guides in Procreate, and my initial intent was to divide the painting into 2 parts. First, do a tutorial section in the first part, and then have a quick break, and then do the rest of the painting so that I can show the editing tricks that I do, because usually I don't get to that part in live streams because I do the color editing later. But I had decided to divide these 2 things into 2 parts, and after the first 30 or 40 minutes, the live stream broke. The connection to YouTube servers disconnected, even though the Wi-Fi in the house was working fine, so I don't know what happened there, but I had to resume the live stream, and after the first video was uploaded, I noticed that it had this like white bar at the lower half of the screen, which I don't think interferes with the information of the tutorial itself, so that's why I didn't take it down. But I just felt completely mortified that I had made that mistake, because that white bar was like 100% my own fault for placing the screens into the wrong order, so I felt like terrible for that. I just had this like whole veil of shame on me doing the second part of the tutorial, because I already felt so defeated that the connection disconnected and that I had made that mistake. So when the second stream ended and I knew that I had to take the dog out for another walk and then come back and continue painting and then do the third one and put them all into a separate playlist, which is kind of messy way to do YouTube, I felt like, should I just delete all of this and pretend that this live stream never happened? For whatever reason, these problems at the time just seemed like horrifying to me. And what made it worse for me is that my boyfriend was coming home and I had promised to take care of the dog for the evening, but I was behind schedule and I hadn't done the last part of the live stream yet, so I had to put the dog into his workroom as he was doing work from home. So I felt terrible for that as well. But before I continue to what happened next, I think it's important to highlight that it happened because you guys have asked me so many times in my different live streams the same question, and that question is like, how do you keep going when you feel like quitting? And I think I've always answered this in like a super optimistic way in my live streams, and now I was at that point, and that question was asked in the second live stream as well. So I was seriously thinking that like, should I just delete all of these videos, go to bed, not do the third part anymore, and just pretend that this never happened? But then I thought that like, I need to take my own damn advice. I need to finish the live stream and finish the painting, because honestly, this painting deserves it. And some of you have seen all of these 3 live streams, so you can probably see how relieved I am at the end, because honestly, And I'm not trying to push my own opinion on you, but like personally for me, I love this painting, the way that it turned out. And I think that this is such good karma that I stuck with the painting, even though it felt like this is literally physically painful to show up on camera and finish this piece when I just feel so horrible for everything that has happened at this point. But then when I saw the finished piece at the end of the last stream, I think you can probably hear from my voice in that video that like I was like honestly super relieved because I had felt like so terrible, and probably because I hadn't had any like lunch the entire day because I had been just like hustling to get all of this done in one single sitting. The reason why I am able to finish these paintings is because I have this habit of finishing everything that I make. I don't start a painting and then just trash it. And there are so many of my paintings where I have felt this way, and I have never said this out loud during a live stream when people ask me this question that like, what do you do when you feel like quitting? Probably every time somebody asks that question on a live stream, I probably already feel like I want to quit when I'm answering that question, but I'm not saying that because I need to stay in this like headspace that I am going to finish this painting. And I just don't let that thought enter my brain while I'm painting at all. It's just not an option. There aren't any paintings that I have thrown away because I felt like quitting. And I'm gonna show here on screen many of the paintings that I felt at the time when I was painting them that this isn't going anywhere. I feel mortified that I'm doing this thing live, that other people are seeing this like massive failure online. All of these paintings, I felt like they are not going anywhere and I want to escape this situation. And all of those paintings I love very much. And especially this bear painting, because I don't know, it just feels like I created one new friend for myself. And I remember one morning waking up and noticing that it was closing 10,000 likes on Instagram, and at that point I felt so like detached from the painting that the bear is like now its own character that just happened in that moment. It just barely made it out alive into the real world. I helped a little bit, but like mostly the bear just came to me, and I remember that morning feeling all day just like a cheerleader, like wanting my bear to get over the 10k line. I was just like celebrating on behalf of the bear, not for myself, when the 10k happened. So that was a great moment, and I'm so grateful for that whole experience. And the only way that I was able to have this experience at all and to have this painting in my gallery is because I didn't quit. And if I had this attitude of like just dropping a painting whenever it's not going my way, I wouldn't have this painting. I would have definitely deleted if this was an option for me, but I love it. I love this painting. And I'm not saying that you have to love these paintings because I love them. It's just, I think, one of the reasons why I'm able to keep painting and loving the work, because I allow myself to love the pieces of art themselves. I don't have to look at my gallery and feel like, oh, I need to like punish myself for doing all of these mistakes, but I get to celebrate the small wins that are there. And I know that I will always keep progressing, whether it's painting or doing these YouTube videos. I know why that white bar happened in the first of the three videos, and now I know how to fix it. So I'm in a way also grateful for that mistake. Keep finishing those paintings, and remember that painting isn't easy. It's pretty damn hard, but it's also worth it, and for me it's the most rewarding thing that I could possibly be doing in life. So the next time somebody asks me during a live stream, how do you keep going when you feel like quitting, I think I'm probably going to just like refer them back to this video, because this is a more honest answer that I can give during a live stream when I feel like I want to quit, because I want to quit like everybody else, but I know that the end result is going to be worth it, and the time that I get to spend with painting is a gift, so I try to be grateful for that. So I hope that this video can help some of you get over those hard parts of painting, and honestly, give yourself like some credit when you finish the painting. Like, feel proud that you went through the hard part and acknowledge that it's hard. It's all right. It doesn't make you a worse person. It makes you a strong person when you finish. So finish strong. I'm Mikko and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!